Rosario is here saying hi.
ええ、おはよう。君はいつも元気ね。何もないのなら、私はとりあえず休んでおくわ。
If it isn't obvious, I prefer Moonstead over Leeway. Well, at least I used to. And I still aesthetically do. But, fuck, I played the Teola quest, character quest, and I fucking despise the fucking pieces of shit in Mondstadt now. Like, there's some decent people there, and I'm like, prima, that's good. Decent humans, that's all I ask for. And then there's those fuckers who look at you and fucking Dolores clan, those fuckers. Coming up here and trying to do some shit. Fucking fuck you too. How about you fucking kill yourself? Oh my god. So. I guess we should start at the entrance. I have this gate and this fence that should go all around, but I don't have enough pieces, so it doesn't. A couple of windmills. Gotta use those natural resources efficiently and make the bread. I have the stone dogs guarding the estate. Rosaria is here, chilling, coming back from work. And Tubby is there because I can't move him. Here's an area with some training weapons that you can spar and a little water fountain. That you can drink from while you train, when you're taking breaks from training. I have some foliage here, some stones, and little spot here where you can relax and read some books. A little bit of a vineyard that's starting to grow. It's a small thing, just get some grapes from there sometimes, nothing more special. The blacksmith's workspace, there's some water to wash stuff, come off a couple of these workbenches, some completed works here and here. Alchemist table next to it, because sometimes you need some alchemy materials when you're working on those tools. And a well to get water and stuff from. Some trees here, like some bushes covering path. I really hope we get some way to put like tiles here, so I can make tiles go all the way to the entrance. I have a little stone garden here, some fishies, and there's no fishies here right now, but I would like to put some there if I could. Some koi fish, and a little music player here, so you can relax to some tunes in the... Fuck, that's crooked. Okay, better fix it someday. But you can enjoy it here, listen to some tunes. Then inside, we have Amber greeting everybody here, probably going off to some Outrider missions. Amber, as a character you play, she's weak as fuck. She's really underperforming. But her design is pretty damn good and she's cute. Her personality is awesome. It's just all around nice. Then we have Jean's room, a little office, like a little table here and a chair. She can do some work. A harp here that auto plays some tunes to lull her to sleep, so she doesn't have. So she would sleep more peacefully. That's the intent there. She already works hard enough. She needs some rest sometimes. A couch to relax and some select books all around. There's a little stage. You could, if you're visiting me here, there could be some performance you want to do. You would do it here, some announcements, told here. A dining table that is soon to be expanded, I hope. And some chairs around it, so everybody can sit. Here's the kitchen. Zhang Li probably uses this the most. She's not here right now, because there can only be so many people in in your house. But a timer there to keep time of anything that's cooking that needs to be kept track of. Some workspace here, a little aisle table here that you can just put your stuff on. Here some materials, keeping spices and shrooms and all that stuff. A little alchemy thing to keep some things cold, because there's no fridge. And little cabinets to keep some more sensitive stuff like flour and things. An oven and a little pan to cook stuff. Here we have a furnace that's just for heating the place. Some little cabinets here. And put some basic stuff there. Here's my crib and my and Yule's crib. Mm-hmm. Yellow, hello. A basic office type thing. Can weigh some stuff, count my coins, write some letters, some books, a big clock, a fancy lamp, a corner to sit here on the couch, and a double bed, because I like the monster bed better. It looks more comfy, but there's no double wide bed, so I put this together, and there's this little gap, and it annoys me to no end. A nightlight here, some more books or cabinets. It's around a cozy place. There's some paintings on the first floor, the walls, and banners next to my door, my room's door. Go up the stairs. And we land in a second floor. Just a little showpiece and a place to sit and like take a break or something. Here is Hu-Tao's room. That little devil likes this place. Got some flowers here, a table, and chairs here, so you can dine here, have a conversation, play some games. Bed, bedside table, some banners and a closet for clothes, and just some, because she has that funeral paralytron, so she not needs some space for documents and stuff that is relevant at the moment. Request board, well, not a request board here, but a notice board, and something to put some stuff that are like relevant and like have to remember to do, and just notices for everybody in the house. A little corner spot to drink some tea in, relax, taking the view. A little common area, I guess. Or chairs to sit on and just relax, some wall scrolls. Ningguan and Beidou almost making out. And more paintings, and Ganyu's room, which is one of the biggest rooms in the house. She needs the space. So, a corner for her secretary stuff, for important documents. A little, some flowers here, because she likes them. She can nibble on them if she wants. A little privacy screen here. Give her some space. Keep her sleeping place separated from everything else. And then there's just a table to put some temporary stuff on, like if you're holding something, you just want to put it down, just put it down there. Some more space for documents and a cabinet for clothes and more greenery to enjoy. Small scrolls and more paintings here on the second floor. That's the interior of the house. I think it's good enough. It could be, there would be more stuff, but I'm pretty satisfied with it right now. The dinner table is something I probably gonna expand at some point. If there comes a good dinner table that it's easy to expand or something. Then I guess we could go here. To the beach. This is the, like, swimming beach. You could come here to relax and swim and stuff. There's lots of space. And there's this tiny, it's not a hill, it's not a mountain, it's a like a stone wall at this point. Yep. There were some hillagers here, but I cleared them out. So now there's just this little cabinet, which is a changing room. You use this to change your swimwear if you didn't want to change at the house. And then there's a couple of pavilions to use. If you want some privacy or have many crops, you can choose one of the other and just chill here and provide some cover from the sun if it's bright outside. And a spot to relax and wash off and just eat some food, I guess. You don't have to care about the sand that much if you're in the pavilion.
Yep.
And I'll go back up. Actually, this is probably the moment I should switch to Mona because she's really useful in... Well, she's fierce. Paste. I'm gonna stick on the gas tonight. She's the fastest character out there because of her sprint. Maybe when Ayaka comes out, she'll be there. Maybe she'll be as fast as Mona. Oh yeah, there's a little water fountain here for aesthetic purposes. And, wouldn't recommend drinking that water, it's probably not that clean. The other water fountain is for drinking. And here is lovely, but this beach isn't as good. There isn't as much space to do stuff. But this leads to this little offshoot village from the main place. Nobody else but me and my adventuring party lives on the in that mansion. There is some residential space for all other people if they would want to be here. And the marketplace. A small little marketplace that expands from the entrance. Some foodstuffs basically and wine. A little place to get a little place to drink some tea, sample some tea. It's kind of messy right now. But it should get more organized as time goes on. There's some wild, well, not wild animals, but pets here going around, running in nature. Some housing, some little hole in the wall shops here, and then and some dining tables to use. You get some, like, I don't know what you would get from this place. Ramen, maybe? Some more animals, some little flower things, and those mailboxes. A well there, and a grinding stone there to do some stuff, grind some stuff. Nothing much else to this. These houses are, there's some leeway houses, this wall in the shop. All in the hole in the wall shops are all leeway design, but a lot of Mondstadt houses here. After this comes another residential area. There's quite a long way away. I have to walk walk this immense distance to get here, and the road doesn't even go on for the whole way. Feet get wet here. But here's some more housing, this time in Liyue style. Some of these little bit bigger, like family houses, a little abandoned shack that should be removed at some point. Some little points of relaxation here. Some markers on the ground level for construction purposes, because this is gonna be expanded at some point. A little bit more houses and another mailbox here. That's basically it.